Good morning students, welcome back to grade 9 mathematics online class. Today we are going to see the continuation of the third chapter algebra. So dear children, take your third chapter note, write it down. In last class we learned about polynomial in one variable, then standard form of a polynomial, degree of the polynomial. Now we are going to see how to find the degree of the polynomial. How to find the degree of the polynomial. Okay. Before last class I gave two question homework for you, isn't it? Take your homework and check the answers. Exercise 3.1, first one. Second subdivision, answer is polynomial. Which of the following expressions of polynomial are polynomial if not give reason? Okay. Then which of the polynomial expression of polynomial? Okay. Which of the following expression? In second one, x square into x minus 1. That means here power is positive, isn't it? Positive given. So it is a polynomial. Polynomial is the answer. Okay. Reason no need. Okay. Then fourth one. Check the answer here. 1 by x power minus 2 is there, isn't it? So this x, 1 by x power minus 2, it will come, numerator means that is x square we will get, isn't it? That is positive value only we will get. So this one also polynomial. Then fifth one also polynomial answer. Okay. Then second one, write the coefficient of x square and x in each of the following polynomials. Okay. First one answer is, check your answer. Coefficient of x square is x square near, which number is given? 2 by 5, isn't it? 2 by 5 is the multiple of this variable, isn't it? Multiple by this variable. Okay, 2 by 5. Then, like that, coefficient of x is minus 3, isn't it? Minus 3 is the multiple of this x. Okay, then second one, coefficient of x square is minus 2. Coefficient of x is minus root 7. Isn't it? Next, third subdivision. Coefficient of x square is pi. Then coefficient of x is minus 1. Okay. Then fourth subdivision. Coefficient of x square is root 3. Coefficient of x is root 2. Okay. Fifth subdivision. Coefficient of x square is 1. Coefficient of x is minus 7 by 2. Did you get this answer? Check your answers. Now you see how to find the degree of the polynomial. Okay. In a polynomial of one variable, the highest power of the variable is called the degree of the polynomial, isn't it? A polynomial of more than one variable, the sum of the powers of the variables in each term is considered and the highest sum is called the degree of the polynomial. Okay. This example you see here, one variable, which is the variable here? X is the variable, isn't it? Then which is the highest power? 2 is the highest power. Okay, here 5x power 1 it will come. Okay, degree is 2. Like that, second one you say 6ab power 5 plus 7ab plus 2. Okay, here our condition is what? More than one variable means sum of the powers, these two powers, a power 1 and b power 5. A power 1 plus this 5. Both also added. 6 we will get. Here power 1, isn't it? A power 1, B power 1. That means 2 we will get. Which is the highest power? 6 is the highest power. So, degree is 6. Okay. Now, example 3.1. Find the degree of each term for the following polynomial and also find the degree of the polynomial. Okay. Here one polynomial is given. First we have to write the given polynomial is 6a b power 8 plus 5a square b cube c square minus 7ab plus 4b square c plus 2. Okay. Here degree of each of the term is given below. We have to write one by one. Okay. Then each of the term, what's the degree we have to find. Okay. First one, this is one term, this is another term, this one, third term, this one, fourth, fifth term. Okay. Then each term shall be find. First term is 6a b power 8. Okay. Has degree. What's the degree you say? Then a power 1, isn't it? Then 1, degree is 1 plus b power 8. Both also add it. Okay. Both sum you should find. Okay. Then equal to 1 plus 8 is 9. Okay. Then second term, 5 a square b cube c square has degree. What's the degree here? A square 2 plus b cube degree power is 3. Then here c square is 1, power is 2. Okay. And equal to here 2 plus 3, 5, isn't it? 5 plus 2 is 7. Have understood? Like that third term, minus here AB, isn't it? 7AB. So, we have to take 7AB has degree. What's the degree here? A power 1, B power 1, isn't it? Then 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Here a power is 1, isn't it? 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay. Then the next one, next term, 4b square c has degree b power 2. Power is 2. C power 1 plus 1. Then equal to 3, isn't it? Here, you see, first term degree is 9. Second term degree is 7. Then third term degree is 2. Fourth term degree is 3, isn't it? Here, afterwards a constant term. Here, no variable, isn't it? No variable. So, degree no need. Here, x power 0. X power 0 means 1. Okay, 2 into 1. Then 2 constant. Okay. Then how we can find out the degree? Our question is find the degree of the polynomial. Okay. Find the degree of each term for the following polynomial. Each term. Okay. So we have to write what? First one, degree of each of the term is given below. First, each of the term is written, isn't it? Then the second question is also find the degree of the polynomial. Okay, also find the degree of the polynomial. So, the degree of the polynomial, what's the question here? 6a b power 8 plus 5 a square b cube c square minus 7ab plus 4b square c plus 2 is equal to
What's the degree of this one? This polynomial? The highest power in the polynomial is the degree. Okay? So, how we can write the answer? The highest power in the polynomial. Which is the highest power, you say? 9 is the highest power, isn't it? Which is the highest power? Then 9 is the highest power. So that's the degree. Okay, therefore 9 is the answer. The degree of the polynomial is 9. Have understood? Next we are going to see types of polynomial. Types of polynomials. Subdivision 1. The polynomial on the basis of number of terms. On the basis of number of terms. Then polynomial we have to find. Okay. Then first one is the monomial. First one, monomial. Okay. What is meant by monomial? A polynomial having only one term is called a what? Monomial. Okay. A polynomial having only one term. Okay. For example, 5 or 6m or 12ab. Okay. Then some more example also you say. Phi A or Phi Y, okay, or 25, okay, this is how many terms? Only one term, isn't it? This is the constant, okay, but only one term is there, isn't it? So, these are called the example for the monomial, okay. Then, second one is the binomial. Binomial. What is meant by binomial? A polynomial having two terms is called a binomial. A polynomial having two terms is called a binomial. Okay. Example. 5x plus 3. How many terms are here? 5x one term. 3 is another term. Okay. Then second example is 4a minus 2. Third example is 10p plus 1. Okay. Then another one example say, then x plus y. Okay. These two terms. Here x plus, this is one term, this is another term. Okay. Then 2x plus 1. 2x plus 1. Then 2, 3y plus root 2. Okay, here how many terms? Two terms, isn't it? So, it is called what? This is binomial. Binomial. Next one, trinomial. Okay, trinomial. What is meant by trinomial? A polynomial having three terms is called a trinomial. Okay, a polynomial having three terms is called a trinomial. Here, example, 4x square plus 8 minus 12. How many terms? 4x square, one term. This is second term, this one third term. Okay, like that. Second example is 3a square plus 4a plus 10. This is one first term, second term, third term. Okay, these are the example for the what? Trinomial. Have you understood? Then polynomial on the basis of number of terms. How many number of terms? Then according to that, then how many types? Three types, isn't it? Monomial, binomial and trinomial. Mono means one, binomial two and trinomial means three. Have you understood? How many terms? Here, three terms. Okay. Second type, polynomial based on degree. Okay, based on degree. First one is constant. A polynomial of degree 0 is called constant polynomial. For example, 5. Okay, here degree is what? 0. Okay, and then 5 minus 7, 2 by 3,
then square root of 5. Okay, the polynomial of degree 0. Degree 0 means how it will come? Say 5 into what? 5 into x power 0. X power 0 is what we can write? 5 into any number, our 0 is 1, isn't it? Equal to 5 only we will get. Here, what? Degree 0, isn't it? 5 means what's the degree here? And then 0 degree. Okay, the polynomial of degree 0 is called a constant polynomial. Okay, then constant values you should write the example. Then linear. A polynomial of degree 1 is called the linear polynomial. Okay, the polynomial of degree 1. Degree 1 means, for example, 410x minus 7. Okay, here which is the variable 410. And then x is the variable here. X power 1. Okay. Degree is 1. So, this is linear polynomial. Okay. Linear polynomial. Okay. For example here, y minus 5. Okay. Y minus 5. Then, z minus 6. Okay. And then, power is degree is what? 1, isn't it? Degree 1. So, it is linear polynomial. Okay. The next one, quadratic polynomial. Quadratic. A polynomial of degree 2 is called a quadratic polynomial. Okay. A polynomial of degree 2. Degree 2 means, here example you see, 2 square root of 5, x square plus 8x minus 4. Okay. 8x minus 4. This is called what? Degree 2, isn't it? This is a quadratic polynomial. Okay. Then, one more example. Can you say here? 4x square plus. Sorry, here x square plus 2x plus 1. Okay. This is. Which polynomial? Quadratic polynomial. How? Then degree is 2, isn't it? Degree 2. Highest power is 2. So it is a quadratic polynomial. Okay. Then cubic polynomial. Okay. A polynomial of degree 3 is called the cubic polynomial. Degree 3. 12y cube. Then second one, 6m cube minus 7m plus 4. Then 30z cube. Okay, 30z cube plus 6. These are the what example for the cubic polynomial. Have understood? Then a constant polynomial means a degree 0 means that is called a constant polynomial. And then a linear polynomial means a degree 1. Quadratic polynomial means a degree 2. Cubic polynomial means degree 3. Have you understood? Then degree of the zero polynomial is not defined. Okay. Degree of the zero polynomial is not defined. Now exercise 3.1. Third sum. Three subdivision I am giving. Remaining homework. Okay. Then first one. Find the degree of the following polynomial. Okay. First one is 1 minus root 2 y square plus y power 7. Okay. 1 minus root 2 y square plus y power 7. Okay. Here, which is the highest power? The two variables here. This is variable. Which is the variable here? Y is the variable. Isn't it? Okay. Then this variable, which is the highest power? Then 7 is the highest power. So, what's the degree? Degree is what? 7. Have understood? Then second one, x cube minus x power 4 plus 6 x power 6 divided by x square. Okay. Here denominator x square given. Okay. So, we have to divide each term, we have to divide it by this x square. So, x cube divided by x square, then minus x power 4 divided by x square, then plus
6 x power 6 divided by x square. Okay, then shall we cancel this one? We cancel this one, x square, and here also x square cancel means we will get what? X power 1, isn't it? Then here x square, and from here also x square cancel, then we will get what? X square. Okay, 2x square cancel. Okay, remaining x square is there. Here x square, this x square cancel, and here x power 6 means 6 times you write it. Okay, 2 times you cancel, then remaining then x power 4 we will get. Have you understood? Then what's the answer you say? X power 1, that means x. X power 1 means what? X. Then minus x square, then plus 6 x power 4. Now you take it. Which is the highest power in this polynomial? Which is the highest power of x? 4, isn't it? Very good. Then therefore degree of the polynomial, degree is what? 4. Have you understood? Next, third subdivision, x cube into x square plus x. Okay, then we have to multiply this one. X cube into x square is what? X power, these two sum we have to find, x power 5. Okay, then afterwards this x cube and this x multiply, then what we will get? Then x power 3 into x power 1, that means then x power 4. Okay, x power 4, then x cube, this 3, then plus this 1. Okay, x power 4. Have you understood? Then here which is the highest power of x? Then 5, isn't it? 5 is the highest power. So degree is what? Degree is 5. Have you understood? First these two multiply. Okay, then afterwards these two multiply. Okay, power you should add it. Okay, degree is 5. Any doubt? Next, fourth sum, rewrite the following polynomial in standard form. Then how we can find out the standard form? See, I have to write the polynomial P of x in the descending, decreasing or increasing order of the powers of x. Okay, decreasing or what? Increasing order of the power of x. That is called the what? Standard form of the polynomial. Isn't it? Already we learned. Like that, should write the answers. How to write the answer here? Shall we write the decreasing power? Okay, which is the greatest power you see? 9. Y power 4. Okay. Read this question. Y square plus square root of 5 y cube minus 11, then minus 7 by 3 y plus 9 y power 4. Isn't it? Here order wise not given. Okay. In the standard form not given. So we have to arrange this one. Okay. Then which is the highest power? 9 y power 4, isn't it? Variable is what? Y, isn't it? Y power 4. So we have to write the answer y 9 y power 4. Okay, then next one is y power 4, then afterwards decreasing power. Decreasing means 4, then afterwards 3, it will come 2, 1. Okay, like that it will come. Then power 3. Next you should write the power 3. So this term fully you should write it. Okay, which is the term you say? Square root of plus square root of 5. Then y cube. Okay, then afterwards, then y cube over. Then afterwards y square it will come. Isn't it? Y square. Check it. Here y square plus y square, isn't it? Plus
y square. And afterwards, y power 1. That means this time. Okay, minus 7 by 3 y. Okay, then afterwards, here minus 11. Okay, last is minus 11. Minus 11 is the constant term. Okay, so we arrange this one. Here y power 4, then y cube, then y square, then y power 1, then minus constant. Have you understood? This is the standard form. Like that, the remaining 3 questions, you do the homework. Okay. Next one, example 3.2. Classify the following based on the number of terms. Based on the number of terms, 3 types we learned, isn't it? What are the terms you say? What are the polynomial? Monomial, binomial, and trinomial. Okay, monomial, binomial, and trinomial. Okay, like that, 3 types we studied, isn't it? Then here, based on the number of terms, first question is, polynomial is given 5t cube plus 6t plus 8t square. Okay, here, number of terms, how many number of terms given? Number of terms, 3 terms, isn't it? That 3 terms we have to write here, 3 terms. Okay, then 3 terms means, what's the answer? What's the type of polynomial is trinomial. Trinomial. Okay, then second one, y minus 7. How many terms? 2 terms. 2 terms. 2 terms means you say? And 2 terms means type is what? Binomial. Binomial. Very good. Then third one, 2 by 3 r power 4. 2 by 3 r power 4. This is one term. Okay. 2 by 3 into. Okay. So 2 by 3 into r power 4. That means one term. Okay. This is one term. One term is what's the time? Monomial. Very good. Monomial. Okay. Fourth one, 6y power 5 plus 3y minus 7. Okay. Here how many terms are given? 1, 2, 3. 3 terms are given, isn't it? So, the number of term, 3 terms. 3 terms means what's the type? Trinomial. Very good. Trinomial. Okay. Then fifth one, 8m square plus 7m square. Okay. These two are m square. Here what's the, which is the variable? Here variable is m, isn't it? M square. Here also m square. Both also like terms. Okay. Both also like term. If you add like terms, we can add. Okay. Can add this like terms. Okay. Here 8 plus 7 is 15. Okay. 15. Common term is m square. Okay. So, what's the answer we can write? These two are like term. Okay. Like terms. Okay. Here like term, we added these two, isn't it? Now, we got the how many terms? Only one term. Okay. Like term. That is one term. Understood? One term. One term means then what's the time? Monomial. Monomial. Have you understood? Here this is not a like term. 6y power 5. Here y power 1. This is not a like term. But here m square, here also m square. These two like term. Have you understood? Any doubt? Like that? For example, here 5x plus 3x.
Here, what's the variable? X is the variable, isn't it? So these two are like terms. Okay, like terms we can add. Okay, then 5 plus 3 is 8. Then these two common is x. Okay, what's the answer? 8x. Have understood? Like that. Only we wrote this question also. Okay, these two are like terms. So if you add this to one term only, we will get this is the monomial. Next one, example 3.3, classify the following polynomials based on their degree. Okay, based on their degree. Here first question is four polynomials are given. Then you find out the degree first, then write the type. Okay, based on their degree you should find out. What are the types based on the degree? Constant polynomial, linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial, isn't it? Then first question is cube root of 4 is set plus 7. Okay, and here what's the degree? What's the which is the variable? Z is the variable, isn't it? Z is the variable. Then power is 1. Okay, here power is what? 1. So what's the degree? Degree is 1. Okay, degree 1. Understood? Degree 1 means, so then what's the type? Linear polynomial. Very good. Linear polynomial. Linear polynomial. Then second one, and then z cube minus z power 2 plus 3. Okay, z power 3 minus z power 2 plus 3. Here, which is the highest degree? Which is the highest degree? 3, isn't it? Therefore, degree what? 3. Degree 3 means, then what we can write? Degree 3 means cubic polynomial. Okay, then third one, square root of 7. Okay, so square root of 7 means, then what's the variable here? Variable not given, isn't it? Okay, and this is called what? Constant polynomial. What is meant by constant polynomial? A polynomial of degree 0. Okay, degree 0 means, then we can write what? It's a constant polynomial. Okay, so degree 0, you write. Okay, degree 0 means that is constant polynomial. Constant polynomial. Any doubt? Then fourth subdivision, y square minus root 8. Okay, y square minus root 8. Here which is the highest degree? Which is the highest power? 2, isn't it? Which is the variable? Y is the variable. Okay, then only one variable is there. Then y square is there. Square means that is a quadratic polynomial, isn't it? Degree 2 means that is quadratic polynomial. Degree 2 means which polynomial? Quadratic polynomial. Have you understood? Very simple this question. Study all definition, then only you can attempt this question answers. Okay? Today's homework is third one, then exercise 3.1, third question, subdivision 4 and 5. Subdivision 4 and 5. Okay, then fourth one, subdivisions. Last one we completed, isn't it? First one, second one, third. Okay, these are the questions for your homework. Okay, can you do homework? Today itself you complete this homework. Okay, in homework, if you have any doubt, you can call me in the doubt clearing session. Okay, thank you students. Have a nice day.